What do you want people to know about Noah?
He was a six-year-old little boy. He loved running and playing with his siblings, and he loved bubble baths and fireflies, and he loved eating the inside of Oreo cookies, and he played the video Gangnam Style ad nauseum in the house, especially the annoying orange version of it. He loved it for some reason. He was just a bundle of energy, like he was supposed to be.
I understand he used to tell his siblings that he managed a taco factory.
Yes, that he was going to split his time as an adult between managing a taco factory and being an astronaut.
Oh, okay.
Which is an interesting juggling act, I'm sure.
How are you holding up? I mean,
I most of the time I'm kind of numb, you know. I think about. And I think every mama out there can relate to the fact of how long it takes to create a baby, those 9 months that you watch every ultrasound and every heartbeat. And it takes 9 months to create a human being, and it takes seconds for an AR-15 to take that away from the surface of this earth. And it wasn't just my son, it was 25 other souls that left this earth that day because that weapon fell into the hands of a tormented soul. And that haunts me.
Is that something you feel you want to be speaking out about moving forward?
I don't think that far. I kind of am on autopilot right now, day
sure.
to day. I do think there's obviously a huge issue in society because we go from a cycle of death, grief and mourning, then there's this numbness that sets in, and then there's sort of this complacency because the next cycle of news comes. And I understand that, it's human nature. We don't want to remember how bad life can get. We don't want to remember that. Because how could we live if we did every day think of that? But it can get that bad. And I didn't think it was going to happen to my family, but it did. And it could happen to others. And if there's a way for that risk to be minimized, whatever the answer is, I'm not sure yet. I haven't wrapped my head around it yet, and I certainly am no stateswoman. I'm no gold in my ear. I don't have the answers, but maybe one day they'll come to somebody. I hope so.
Where do you find the strength? I mean, you spoke at Noah's funeral, and so many mothers and fathers have spoken at their children's funerals.
I don't think that source comes from within us. I think it comes through us, from our children. They wanted to know they were here and they mattered. They all had families and they mattered. And so did all the educators who died that day. They all mattered. They all had families. They all had friends. They all had, you know, if I asked everybody in this world who has ever loved someone, who has ever had a human being in their life who is essential to their well-being to raise their hand, I don't think there'd be many hands down in this world. And every one of those hands is a reason why those weapons should not be out in the general public.
Is there anything else you want to say?
I don't think so, Anderson. I think I've said everything I want to say. I'm grieving. That's all. Like we all.